My name is Rich Lambert, and I am the creative director on The Elder Scrolls Online. The Elder Scrolls Online is an online game that is focused on virtual worlds. It is your personal journey through the world, and it is focused on that exploration. It is focused on you being able to do what you want, any way you want, without having to worry about making a mistake. You can always change your ideas, your choices at that later date. I think the charm in Elder Scrolls, and in Elder Scrolls Online in particular, is that you can talk to 10 different people, all playing the game, and they will all tell you they played a different way. And that's the magic. The world is so big, it really is a virtual world. You can, you know, battle other players, you can do 12-player trials, which is, you know, very high-end content. You can do veteran dungeons, you can play in the housing system, which is incredibly intricate. Craft, do quests. It really is just this huge world. And so there's lots of freedom for players to express themselves in their own ways. ESO has had a long development cycle. We started in 2007. My favorite bits of starting was for years beforehand, I worked with Bethesda Game Studios, worked on Oblivion, and I always wanted to make an online game. And I would hound Todd Howard to do that. And there were always other things we had to focus on and have to do. And one day he called me into his office and Matt Firor, who is the general manager and president of ZeniMax Online Studios now, was in his office. And he introduced me to Matt and introduced Matt to me. I was the guy that always wanted to make Elder Scrolls an MMO. And he pleaded with Matt to take me and get him out of his hair. And it's been 15 years later, and we're still working on The Elder Scrolls Online. There's many stories. We've spent a long time working on The Elder Scrolls Online, but one story that particularly comes to mind is when we were working on the Dark Brotherhood. The Dark Brotherhood is essentially an assassin's guild, and we had all obviously played Oblivion, played Skyrim. We thought we really understood all the nuance to the Dark Brotherhood and what they were about. So we wrote a storyline pitch of what we wanted to do and the type of story we wanted to tell. And then we sat down with the Bethesda Game Studio team. And we had a 3-page document of stories and quests that we wanted to do. And Emil, who was the designer responsible for the Dark Brotherhood at the time, sat me down and said, listen, you got some things right, you got a lot of things wrong, here's where you got things wrong. And it ended up being 7 pages of feedback on a 3-page document. And so that just goes to show that even people who live and breathe the game don't necessarily understand all the nuance, and it requires a lot of collaboration between the studios. And so that was really interesting. That was a lot of fun to do that. And that is something that we have continued to do over the years, is working with the Bethesda team to make sure we adhere to the IP and we tell the same types of stories that they would. I think the best bit of advice I can give new console players, or just console players in general, is to take your time. Enjoy the story, learn about the game. ESO is not a game where you have to rush to the maximum level in order for it to open up and really become playable. You can play it from the outset. And so just take your time, enjoy the ride, and ask questions. The community is very open and loves to talk about Elder Scrolls and loves to help people. Just enjoy yourself. I would like to personally welcome them to Tamriel. We are very, very excited to be able to share this world with you, and we can't wait for you all to be able to explore the world in your native language. Thank you all for watching. I really appreciate your time, and we will see you all in Tamriel.